Below are the steps Stephen used to correctly solve the equation 6x is equal to 3 times x plus 4 for x. Step 1 is missing. What could Stephen have written for step 1? So let's see. So this is the original equation. They give us a blank for step 1, and then we see that he eventually gets to 3x equals 12. Then he divides both sides by 3, and he gets to x equals 4. So the best way I could think about doing this is just think, well, what would I do? Well, if I saw something like this, my instinct would be to distribute this 3 so that I could start, separating the parts of this expression that have a variable, that have the x, and the parts that are constant. So let's try to distribute this 3 and see what we get, and see if that's a reasonable step for the direction that Stephen went in. So if we do that, we would get 6x is equal to, we haven't changed the left-hand side, and the right-hand side, 3 times x is 3x, and then 3 times 4 is 12. So you get 6x is equal to 3x plus 12. Now, if I were to just, if I don't even look at what Stephen's doing right over here, if I'm trying to solve 4x, what would be the next thing that I would do? Well, I would try to isolate all of the x's on one side, and if I want all the x's on the left-hand side, I would subtract 3x from both sides. And so if you subtract 3x from both sides, you would then get Stephen's second step right over here. So this looks like, a completely reasonable first step for Stephen. The first step is he distributes the 3 to get this expression. Then he subtracts 3x from both sides to get 3x is equal to 12. And then he divides both sides by 3 to get x is equal to 4.